r/AskReddit. A nuclear strike will happen in 20 minutes. Where do you go? Walk in a circle. Stare at the floor. Scratch my head. Sigh. Are you a cat? I'd grab a huge pole and hold it between my legs so that when my shadow gets burnt into the ground, people at the sight of the explosion will say, "Wow. This was the home of the man with the world's biggest dick." Creative. Haha, it's funny. But he's quoting from QI. Under a desk. Because everyone knows you can survive nuclear blast fallout with a good ole duck and cover, right? Getting under your desk is a good way to prevent flying glass injuries and injuries from falling objects or ceiling tiles. So yes. Not a bad first move once you see the flash. Once you see the flash, doesn't that mean you're blind now? If you see the flash everywhere. Depending on your proximity, you could be reduced to your component atoms instantaneously or die of radiation poisoning days or years later. Proximity and yield. Edit. Nuclearsecrecy.com link. My wife works about 20 minutes from me. I'd give her a call. We'd meet halfway. And spend the last 10 minutes of our life furiously having sex in public. What will you do for the other 9 minutes and 30 seconds? Wrecked. Go home. Put my speakers to its max volume and play John Cena's theme song for 20 minutes. Brrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr I would also go to the refrigerator. But not because I think I can hide in there and survive the blast. Because there's cake in there, and if I'm going to die in 20 minutes, I might as well eat some bloody cake first. Cake or death? To hell, most likely. From my experience in reading people's daily pleasures, maybe take a shower in the dark. And try a shower beer. I've never done it. But hey oh, this is quite Nick. Doom. The epicenter. Rather die instantly than slowly due to radiation poisoning. I'm not far from MIT. So I'll try to be one of the founding members of the institution. Why not go to Fenway Park and barricade the doors? I'm on the other side of the river. I will go to the Minnesota Vikings end zone. That's a place without touchdowns. I laughed then cried. The Vikings scored the second most points in the division last year. So they aren't exactly the best target for that joke. Glasgow. It's not like it would change anything. Nowhere. I call my loved ones. They are too far away for me to reach them in time. Then presumably grab a final drink and lie on the living room floor with a paper bag over my head and wait. Paper bag? Done. Plastic bags are dangerous. To bed. I got hit to not do tomorrow. There are some large gypsum mines about 20 minutes from my house. Probably there. Just coming off duty. So. Probably back into the damn bunker we've been guarding all day. What the hell is going on? You wanna tell us something? Probably stay on Reddit. I'm at ground zero. Ask me any. Not only did his phone survive the blast, but somehow the detonation managed to send his comment. What a thoughtful atomic bomb. I live in a small town in NC. I think the closest likely target they'd strike would be about 10 hours away in DC. I don't think the fallout would be too bad over here. They might strike Atlanta. But I doubt it. That's about 4-5 hours away. 270-ish miles. Again. The fallout looks like I could survive it. The closest metropolitan area to me is Charlotte. But Charlotte seems like a pretty unlikely target. But if so, that would probably get me. As it's 74 miles away and it looks like that would be enough exposure to radiation to kill me. I live right at the foot of the mountains. I can get there in about 20 minutes if I speed. There are a lot of good places to go up there. And I have a tent. About the best I could do. I'd say my survival is relatively slim. But I'd try. Check out the map. See how close the nearest blast will be to you. That'll determine if you survive the first hour. And how much direct radiation. Unfortunately, you're on the East Coast. So the jet stream is going to carry all that radiation from the rest of the country over your head. That is, of course, If the firestorms, which are pretty likely to develop along the east coast, don't get you first. If a total nuclear war starts, we pretty much have to hope the government has a very effective and very secret missile defense shield. If the rest of the world launches their whole arsenal and succeeds with the strikes, the most painless thing you can do is to eat a bullet. I always thought Charlotte would be a candidate to get hit. What with the banking industry and stuff here? I don't know. And now I'm on a list. And that's the ducking reason you woke me up for? Continues sleep. Ducking hardcore. Head to the Winchester. Have a pint. And hope this whole thing will blow over. Wait. But the real question is, what kind of beer would you have? A blue bomber? There's a Cold War nuclear bunker 25 minutes from my house. 25 minutes at normal road speeds. You'd be driving as fast as you can. What if the cops pull you over for speeding? A nuclear strike where? The USA? If so, I'll tune in CNN and watch it. Since I live in the other tip of the continent, I can't even get out of the city in 20 minutes. So probably to a drug dealer. Home. I'd get there just in time to get the family in the basement. Kiss my girl goodbye. And watch as the city bleeds before the red turns to black. Use my overlords to find that duckin' ghost and kill it with my lings. 20 minutes is more than enough time to get out of the blast zone of all but the biggest nuclear bombs. And even with those gigantic ones, a cellar or well-insulated building would be enough to protect you from the thermal blast if you were able to drive 20 minutes away from the epicenter. Source, nuclearsecrecy.com link. Thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe to RedditQueen for the best daily content.